गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी डिस्कस द सेवंथ चैप्टर इन अवर साइंस टेक्स्ट बुक लेट अस मेजर। इन दिस लेसन नाउ वी डिस्कस द मेजरमेंट ऑफ इरेगुलर प्लेन सरफेस एंड मेजरमेंट ऑफ एक्विलेटरल वॉल्यूम एंड मेजरमेंट ऑफ लिक्विड्स Measuring cylinder, measurement of volume of irregular solids using a measuring cylinder. Okay, students, all of you take your textbook, page number 78. Activity 6, measurement of irregular plane surface. See this diagram. One graph paper is there and leaf is placed on the surface of this graph paper. And draw the border line of this leaf with help of a pencil on the graph sheet. Measurement of irregular plane surface. Let us find out the area of irregular surface. Say a banana peel or a leaf which has irregular shape. Place the leaf on a graph paper as shown in figure. Place a leaf on a graph paper shown in figure. Make the boundary of the piece of a leaf on the graph paper with a pencil. Draw the boundary line of leaf with the help of pencil and graph paper. Count the number of complete squares inside the boundary. Count the number of boundaries present inside the boundary of leaf. Also count those squares inside the boundary which are half or greater than half. Also you count the one square which contain half square or more than half square, we count as a one complete square. Add this to number of complete square. That this total number of squares inside the boundary gives the area of the leaf. Okay. If there are n squares inside the boundary, n squares of graph sheet, the area of the leaf become n centimeter square. Or n square centimeter. Neglect those squares inside the boundary which are less than half. The boundary line having inside the boundary line of the leaf, the square having less than half of square, inside the boundary, that square is we neglect, less than square inside the boundary of the leaf. This process will give us the value of area which is close to the actual area of the leaf, actual area of the any given irregular shape. How can you use the graph paper to get a more accurate answer? Okay, we'll measure in our measurement of volume of liquid, volume of gas, or volume of solid. How do you find the volume of a given solid? Mr. John is constructed a house. She needs sand and required about prices. The supplier informed her that two tractor loads of sand cost of 4,000 and one lorry load of sand cost of about 4,000. So two loads of tractor and one load of lorry, the same cost 4,000 and 4,000. Which deal is cheaper for Mr. John, a lorry or a tractor? So how can you decide the load has more quantity of the sand? Which load is more quantity, tractor load or two tractor loads or one lorry load? to decide the quantity contained either in a lorry or a tractor, we need to know the volume of the body of a lorry as well as that the body of a tractor. Volume is measure of the extent of space, extra space occupied by the body. Volume is a space occupied by the body. It is called volume. Space occupied by or any substance, it is called volume. Unit of volume is in CGS system measures cubic centimeter. Unit of volume in MKS system cubic meter or meter cube. Measurement of volume of liquids. Next one, measurement of volume of given liquid. How can you measure the volume of kerosene or petrol or diesel or milk or given any liquid? How do you decide the volume of a milk? So we use some measuring cylinders to measure the volume of liquids. Such as the kerosene, milk, oil, water, etc. The volume of liquids is expressed in liters or milliliters. Okay. Next one, measuring cylinder. This is the measuring cylinder. Page number 79. This is the measuring cylinder. Are also called measuring jar also. It is a cylindrical shape. Measuring cylinder. It is a cylindrical in shape with graduations marked on its body. It graduations are engraved on the surface of this measuring cylinder up to 0 to 90 ml. Here 0 to 90 milliliters. They are used in the laboratories to measure the certain volume of a liquid and measure the milk, oil, etc. by sharp papers. We can fill it with the liquid to measure and then read the marking at the lowest point of the concave surface of liquid. This is the lowest mark. We measure the volume of liquid. We must bring our eyes in line with this level. Bring our eyes line with this level of liquid and then read it. The reading of that liquid is called volume of that given liquid. Apart from measuring the volume of liquid, we also measure the volumes of solids. For example, loose solids like sand, clay, sometimes cement, and ready mix of the cement also measure in this method. What is the standard unit of measurement of or measuring of volume of solids? Are you able to measure the volume of loose solids? Yes, so we are able to measure the volume of loose solids. How can you decide a standard unit of volume of a solid? A standard unit of volume of solid. Look at the figure 18. This is the figure 18. Now we calculate the volume of this empty box. Volume of this empty bigger box. Now we take some small square box. Arrange these all small square box in this empty bigger box. The total number of small squares fitted in this box here gives the volume of this box. Volume of the given box. There are certain number of identical cubes of length, breadth and height 1 cm each. These are the square boxes. Length 1 cm, breadth 1 cm, height also 1 cm. Okay, 1 cm. And a cardboard box of length 3 cm, 2 cm breadth and 2 cm height. This is the cardboard box. Length 3 cm and breadth 2 cm, height also 2 cm. Place 3 cubes in a line as to cover the entire length. Entire length of the given bigger box along the side of this line. Place another line of 3 cubes so that completely cover the base of the box. These cubes are completely cover the base of the box. How many cubes have you used to so far? Used so far. How many cubes do you need to cover the entire empty space in the box? That cubes gives the volume of given empty box in cubic centimeter. Place more cubes over this set of blocks so that the total space is occupied by the blocks. Total cubes occupied by the blocks. Calculate the number of cubes occupied the rectangular box. How many cubes occupied in the rectangular box gives the volume of given empty box? Can you guess volume of rectangular box? Yes, we calculate to guess the volume of rectangular box. Since the each cube has a measurement 1 cm length, 1 cm breadth and 1 cm height, that is 1 cubic centimeter. The volume of cube is equal to 1 cm into 1 cm into 1 cm, that equal to 1 cm cube, which is known as 1 cubic centimeter and written as 1 cm cube. Cubic centimeter is the standard unit for the measurement of volume of given solid. Cubic centimeter is the standard unit for measuring the given solid, volume of given solid. Therefore, the volume of the rectangular cardboard is equal to the total number of cubes occupying it. Total number of cubes occupying the empty box gives the volume of that given box. Therefore, the volume of rectangular cardboard box is 12 into 1 centimeter. That equal to 12 cubic centimeter or 12 centimeter cube. If you multiply length, breadth and height, it would be 3 cm into 2 cm into 2 cm. That is the volume of given empty box. Length 3 cm, breadth 2 cm, height 2 cm. 3 into 2 into 2, that equal to 12 cm cube. Therefore, we can say the volume of box is equal to length into breadth into height. Length into breadth into height. That is equal to centimeter into centimeter into centimeter. That is the cubic centimeter. Okay, students, we will meet in the next class. Thank you.